Hello, everybody, and welcome to RTC TV 4. My name is Dakota Hayden, and I'll be running the complete show for tonight. That's right, nobody else here, just me. I'll be running camera and commentary, so it's going to be one of two things tonight. Either it's going to be a fantastic show, or it's going to be a complete disaster. I'm hoping for the first one, but we'll find out. In tonight's matchup, we got varsity boys basketball, the Casting Comets against the Rochester Zebras. So it should be an interesting matchup for as far as I know. Both teams out on the court, getting all set up, ready to go for the tip-off. Everyone's all set up and ready to go. And here we go. Rochester's going to start off with the ball. They're going to take it over to their side of the court. Got a really nice offense going so far. Everything nice and quick-paced. Let's see if that changes up throughout the night here. Giving the ball passed around the arc. Going for a three. Couldn't get it going. Hunter Shainlop on the rebound, getting it over to Eli Douglas. Eli over to Brandon, or Kinzer. Kinzer pulling it around, get it to Eli. Eli back over to Kinzer. Kinzer then back over to Eli. Eli with a three. Lands it. Straight three to put Comets on the board. Early on in the game, too. That's surprising. Eli's been having trouble nailing his threes in the past few games, so glad to see he's finally starting to get the hang of it. Comets with the steal on the ball. Eli with the ball again. Getting it over to Trenton. Trenton pulled around the arc. Eli for another three. Nails that one, too. That's two in a row. Hot dog. What a way to start off the game. Rochester looking to try and get it in the paint. Carrying it back out to the arc. And try for a two. Got it straight in. Easy two. Kinzer now with the ball. Getting over to Trenton. Trenton all the way over to the freshman, Hunter. Hunter then back out to Trenton. Trenton tried to get it over to Ranz. It was stolen by Rochester. Put up for an easy layup. Kinzer now will return the ball back to our side. Comets need to start making some more points here. Can't let Rochester catch him. Ranz off to Kinzer. Kinzer getting up. Couldn't get it in. Rochester having a little bit of trouble with the ball. It'll be sent right back over Caston's way. Eli getting the ball into Kinzer. That's Kinzer thinking. Getting it organized, Eli. Dribbling it over. Getting over to Kinzer for a three. Nailed that one too. Comets have been nothing but three so far to start off tonight. Solid. Rochester now trying to get something going for him. Can't find an opening out in the arc. Trying to go in. They put up for two. Can't get to land. They're on the rebound, though. Put it for three. Rochester can't make that one either. Hunter on the rebound. Got over to Eli. Eli all the way over to Kinzer. Travel on Kinzer. That'll be Kinzer's first foul of the game. Rochester's ball. Let's see what Rochester can get going here. I'm liking the Comets defense tonight. It's a lot better than it has been the past couple weeks. Looks like they're ready to bring their A game out here tonight. Rochester with a jumper. Got in for two. That'll put him up 6-9. Eli now with the ball. Got over to Kinzer. Kinzer dribbling up and getting it all the way over to Trenton. Trenton back to Eli. Eli then driving in to put it up. They couldn't get in for two. Almost out on Rochester. The Zebras wouldn't get a move going. Push and foul. Who was that foul on? I couldn't get that going. 13, that would have been on Shane Lobb. First team, first. Back in for the Zebras is 15, Jordan Reinhold. Now, I might have been mistaken, but I swore Kinzer got called for a travel. Interesting. All right, well, we'll continue on. Zebras taking the ball into play for a... We were going for a three. They were on the rebound. Couldn't get it to fall in. Trenton, you keep hold of that. There we go. Got it up to Hunter. Nice recovery by Trenton. Kinzer now with the ball, sending all the way to Eli. Eli with another three. Couldn't get it to fall. Comets couldn't get on that offensive rebound. Zebras bringing it back around their way. Zebras now tried to get into the paint. They're putting it up for three. Can't get it to fall. The Comets can't get on that rebound. That's going to kill them if they can't get it going. For another three by Rochester. Can't get it to fall. Rochester is just not having any luck here in the first quarter. Which, granted, is not a bad thing for the Comets, but still. Now we got a foul on Kinzer. I swore he had to travel earlier, but I could be mistaken. Zebras still with the ball with 3 minutes and 44 seconds left in the first. Now Comets set up to take on the defensive here. Zebras. He's way open. He could have pulled it if he wanted to. He's not going to. He's going to send it back to the arc. Now he's going to pull it. Finally nail one of the threes, tying the game up at nine. Kinzer with the ball. Tried to get over to Rands. Rochester's going to... Nope, Rands recovered it. Got it back out to Kinzer. It was a nice recover. Rochester still with the steal, though. Bring it back over to their side. This isn't looking good now. Rochester putting it up for an easy two. Comets need to get on the ball here, literally. Eli getting it over to Trenton. Trenton getting it back over to Eli. And Eli into Rands. Rands over to Hunter. Hunter all the way over to Kinzer. Kinzer's going to put it up for a three. Dang it. Rands on the offensive rebound. He's going to put it up for two. Couldn't get it up. Now Rochester with an easy layup. Didn't even look like he tried for that one. Kinzer with the ball. Got it over to Hunter. Hunter back over to Trenton and then back into Hunter. Hunter back to Trenton. Trenton to Kinzer. What's Kinzer going to do? Get over to Eli. Eli got to send it back to Kinzer's way. He's going to drive in a little. Take it out to Shane Lobb. Shane Lobb back over to Eli. Eli Kinzer. Oh, he could have popped it. Back to Eli. Eli with the three. Swish. Nailing him. I think he's only missed one so far. Or maybe that was Kinzer. Rochester with the three, attempt of their own. Couldn't get it to fall. Pushing. That'll be on Shane Lobb. That's okay. That's okay. Oh. Well, my bad. That was on Eli. We got number 21, Brady Hartman, coming in for Trenton Howard. Now Rochester with the ball. Send it out to the arc. Seems like they're looking for a three. Can they get it going? I send it into the paint to put it up. Easy two, easy two. Hartman gets it over to Eli and then over to Kinzer. Kinzer then back to Eli. Eli back to Kinzer. They're exchanging. Kinzer to Hartman. Hartman dribbling into Kinzer. Kinzer driving in to put it up. Did he get the foul? He got the foul. Oh, put him on the line. Solid move. Now, Comets have been so far. Eli's been able to hit his threes, so let's hope our free throw game is up. First one sinks in for Kinzer. Let's hope for a second one just like that. We got Trenton Howard coming back in for Hunter Shane Lobb. Kinzer's prepping. Swish! Both free throws are good. Rochester. The Zebras. Looking for an opening, a little bit of mishap on the pass. Rochester recovers, though. Sends it up. Getting stuffed. Still gets the two. Kinzer now with the ball. Kinzer sends it all the way over to Trenton. Trenton hopping it up to Eli. Eli back to Trenton. Almost had a bit of a mishap there. Trenton all the way over to Eli. He could have popped it up. He's driving in base, sends it back out to... Eli's going to get called for the travel. Yikes. Or maybe he's not going to get called for the travel. Well, the ref made a travel sign. Your signal for a travel. Maybe I'm mistaken. Very much so. Rochester couldn't get the layup, but they got on the rebound. They're now leading 19-14, it looks like. Roughly 40 seconds left in the first. It's been quite a long first quarter. Usually doesn't feel this long, but, you know, it'll be fine. Seems like a good game so far. Hartman tried to get the pass over to Trenton. Was not getting there. Stolen by Rochester. They're going to take it nice and slow and try and run out the clock while they're still ahead. Smart thinking. Yep. They're more than likely taking their time, or at least making it where they get one last shot in. They're driving in. Jumper for two. Solid two. Trenton getting over to Eli. Clock's ticking. They got to send it up. Kinzer for three. Couldn't get it in. That's going to end it for the first quarter. Unfortunate. But it would have been pretty cool to get a buzzer beater if at the end of the first quarter. Comets have been suffering so far a lot from buzzer beaters these past few games. Or more specifically, the West Central games. Girls varsity lost to West Central girls varsity by a buzzer beater in the fourth quarter. Comets boys varsity went to overtime, but then ended up losing by 10. I forget exactly what the score was. It might have been like 70-60, if I do recall. But around that. But so far, I'm very impressed with the Comets offensive coming back into it against Rochester, even though we are behind by 7. But so far, Eli's been nailing his threes, which that's good to see. And so far, me personally, I'm feeling pretty good right now. And I feel pretty confident that Comets could come back around and pull off the win. Just got to stay calm, cool, and collective. I'm about as sure as I can keep this commentary going solo for the rest of this game. All right, now we're heading into the second quarter.
It'll be the Comets ball to start the second quarter. The
Comets will have possession of the ball to start off the second quarter. Another 8 minutes. Another 8 minutes of scoring. Trenton over to Kinzer. Kinzer into Hartman. Hartman's going to get it back over to Trenton. Trenton to Eli. What's their game plan here for the offense? Eli back to Trenton. Excuse me. Trenton then trying to find someone. Someone's got to get in there to help him. Trenton got over to Kinzer. They're dribbling around, staying on the arc. Got over to Eli. Eli then over to Kinzer again for a deep three. Couldn't get it in. Hunter saving the ball, but getting it into the hands of the Zebras. The Zebras looking to kind of give themselves a nice cushion of a lead here. Now seeing on that defense, it's a nice deflection, I have to say. Not really a block by Hunter. You keep the ball out. Rochester couldn't get the ball to fall on the layup. Kinzer with the rebound. Taking things nice and easy, slowing things down a tad bit. Trenton with the ball. Trenton then going to send it back over to Kinzer. Ooh, Kinzer with the spin move. Got it back out to Trenton. Trenton then over to Eli. What are you thinking? Ref's calling a foul. Be Rochester's ball again. I don't think I've seen one of those fouls that the refs called, so I don't exactly know how to call it. My basketball knowledge may be more than football, but it is still limited. Rochester with the three of their own. Can't get it to fall. And the ball will head out, making it an automatic casting ball. We got 23. Matthew Ranz coming in for Brady Hartman. Oh, Ranzi. Ranzi was not part of the West Central game. I'm not really so sure why. I didn't really ask around why. But it seems like he would have been a valuable asset to put in the game back there. We'll see if he can make up for it tonight. Kinzer gets the ball over to Eli. Eli staying on the arc. Foul called on Eli. Not really so sure what that was for about either. For about. Yes, my grammar is top-notch tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Zebras with the ball. Keeping it on the arc. Yeah. Try and get some momentum moving. Dribbling or passing into the paint. Put it up. Couldn't get it to go. They're on those rebounds, though, which is probably what's helping them out here in the long run. Nice easy jumper by Rochester, giving them the easy two. Kinzer now with the ball. Comet's got to get things turning around for him here in the first half. Chainlop with the ball. He needs some help. Someone needs to get in there and help him. He gets over to Ranz. Ranz all the way out to Trenton. Trenton for three. Couldn't get it to fall. Ranz on the offensive rebound. Sends it out to Eli. Eli's going to dribble it in and get it out to Kinzer for three. There we go. Now put Comet's up to 17. Rochester now with the ball. They're looking to counteract that point game by the Comets, that's for sure. Staying around the arc. And then all the way to the other side, they're going to drive in a little. Oh, nice spin move. Now put up for a three. That's going to go right in there. I am not liking this one little bit. Trenton got the ball over to Kinzer. Kinzer all the way over to Trenton. Trenton to Eli. Eli for a three. Couldn't get to fall. That might be his first missed three of the game, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe the second. Either or. Zebras with the ball. Three of their own. Can't get it to fall. Trenton on the rebound. Got over to Eli. Eli over to Kinzer. Kinzer trying to get something going. Got over to Eli. Eli's then going to drive in a little bit to put up for two. Couldn't get it in, but he gets the foul, and that's going to put him on the line. He's been pretty efficient at his threes, but can he hit the free throws? We're about to find out. First one sinks for Eli. We had a full timeout called by the Rochester Zebras. With about 4 minutes and 2 seconds left to go in the first. I mean second. My bad. Well, I do have to say, so far it's been a pretty interesting game. If my math serves me correct, we're only down by eight. Which, in my opinion, shouldn't be too bad to make up. So I'm really hoping we can turn things around by the end of the second quarter and maybe by the beginning of the first half. Comets could really use a win right about now. As far as the JV game went, I was able to watch a little bit of it, and the Rochester Zebras did beat the Caston Comets for the JV game. The Caston had 11, and I want to say the Zebras had somewhere in the 30s. So it wasn't looking too good there. But it looks like our varsity is faring just a tad bit more better than our JV is, so far anyway. I'm hoping not to have that quite drastic of a point deficit there in the varsity game as there was in the JV game. But, you know, we never know, so about gonna find out. Eli still with one more free throw to go. Now, I see the ideology, if that's the right term of words, of why you would call a timeout in the middle of shooting the second free throw. But I don't think it worked out too well. Second one sank. Zebras now with the ball. They're keeping around the outside of the arc. What are they hunting for? Hunting for a three? Could be. He's gonna put it up. And he does. Going for a three. Couldn't get it to fall. Rand's on the rebound. And he's gonna wait and get it over to Kinzer. Comets need to start making some shots here and scoring some points. Racking it up on the board. Trent with the ball. Get it back over to Kinzer. Kinzer for a three. Swish. Boom. Rochester now with the ball. And Kasten starting to close the gap a little bit with that three. Zebras. They seem to be constantly looking for threes here. Or an opening to drive in. Like right there. Oh, he could have had it. Shoots it up for a three. That sinks for Rochester. Kinzer now with the ball. Send it over to Eli. Eli's going to send it into Rand, or try and send it into Rand. It's going to get stolen by the Zebras. And he's got to put it up for, whoa! That Zebra's looking like he was going to go for and dunk it. He didn't get enough height for that. Yikes. He's got a pushing foul on him anyway. Rands must have got him in mid-flight, sending him to the line.
23, Brady Perez at the line for two shots.
But he was looking like he was going to dunk. Maybe that wasn't the idea. Maybe he was just pushed. Either way, I would have been impressed. And I've seen my share of dunks, mostly at the Logan game. But that's to be expected. Rochester couldn't get the first free throw to fall for him. And second one follows suit. Trenton on the rebound. Got over to Kinzer. Kinzer now. Blocking foul called on Rochester. Must be the exact reason why Kinzer seemed to have slipped up. Not so sure. I am dealt with the very strenuous task of keeping the camera in line as well as spitting out words. It's not as easy as you think. Luke Lau is now into play, and Rochester with the steal of the ball to put up for an easy layup. Luke Lau, he's in for Eli, if I'm not mistaken. Double dribble on Trenton. That's not going to suit well for us. 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the second. Rochester is leading by 9. All right. Rochester staying on the outside. Oh, shot it into the paint to put it up for an easy 2. Comets defense is starting to slack a little bit. Comets get hit with another foul. Timeout by the Comets for 30 seconds. The Comets need to get something running for them that's good. They've been getting too many fouls called on them already in the second half. I mean, not the whoa, boy, it's a night. Already in the first half. Whether it be double dribbles or anything that's been called for them, really. No foul is a good foul, unless it's intentional for a shooting foul. But then again, that's also called on the opposing team. So unless you're wanting to stall for time, I guess that also works too. I guess there's multiple ways now that I think about it that a foul can be useful, but not all the time is it ever useful. All right, timeout is officially up. The team's taking their places back on the court. Hopefully Coach Evans down for the Comets is able to speak some words of wisdom into their ears to get them running here. Camera's having a little bit of a movement of its own. Rochester with the ball. Putting it up for a three. Yikes, sank that one. Sank it like a ship. Comets need to get something rolling for him. Kinzer, Eli, Trenton with the ball. Trenton all the way over to Rands. Rands needs some help. Anybody. Trenton. Trenton now getting past his oppressors. Getting it out to Eli. What's Eli going to do with it? Got a minute 35 left on the board. Eli getting over to Trenton. Trenton now. Where's he going? Getting it over to Rands. Rands out to Eli. Guys isn't going to drive in. Put up for a jumper. Couldn't get it to fall. Rochester just storming for the basket. Somebody out on Kasten. Trenton got a hand in there to get it out of bounds. Man. Rochester now. Oh, he could have pulled it. Send it out, keeping it outside the arc. Anything? Anything? He's thinking. Giving it out. Gonna pull it. He can. He's gonna put up a three. That's gonna sink. Already first half, and both teams surpassing their previous JV's team score that they were able to put up the board. I'm almost certain of that. Kinzer tried to get something to go for him. Rochester with the steal, putting it up for, couldn't even get it up for a layup. Arm reaching foul, or arm grabbing foul on Rochester. Giving it over to Kasten. Four fouls for the Zebras and only five for the Comets here in the second quarter. Kinzer getting the ball to Trenton. Trenton back to Kinzer. And back to Trenton. And over to Hunter. And to Kinzer for a three. Couldn't get it to fall. Hunter on the rebound to put it up for two. Solid. If it can't be a three, might as well make it a two. 20 seconds left on the board. And counting. Rochester going to try and hold things out here a little bit longer. Try and make a final play of this first half. The time clock's ticking. They got put up. You know, drive in, put it up for a jumper. Can't get it to fall. Rands is on the rebound, but that's going to end it for the second quarter. Thank you all for tuning in to RTC TV4 and bearing my voice thus far. We'll be back with you right after the break. All right. Welcome back, everybody, to RTC TV4. In case you forgot, my name is Dakota Hayden, and it's just me solo running the show tonight, folks. So if you thought you had enough of my voice the first half, well, you're out of luck. All right. Starting off the second half, Rochester's got the ball. They're keeping around the arc so far. Well, then again, they just started. Looks like they're keeping the ball around on the arc. Might be looking for a three. So far, Rochester leads 39-24. And he's going to drive in. They could have just put it up. Stolen by Rands. He's going to send it out to Eli and bring it on our side of the court. Eli then gets it into or over to Trenton. And Trenton to Kinzer. Kinzer to Eli. Eli back to Trenton. Trenton now back over to Kinzer. Comets keeping on the arc. Oh, he could have just popped it up right there. Out on Rochester. Keep it Kasten's ball. All right. Kinzer's going to send the ball all the way out to Eli. And Eli's going to transfer it over to Trenton. Trenton then tried to get it into Rands. That's still going to be out on Rochester. Therefore, it'll be Comets ball. Looks like one of the Rochester kids got a bit of a, maybe a little bit of a sprain going on there. Or maybe not a sprain, but a cramp going on there. He'll get swapped out. Kinzer checking the ball into Eli. Eli now. Sending it off to Trenton. Trenton over to Kinzer. Kinzer with a three. Can't get it to fall. Rochester was on that rebound. They're going to bring it over to their side. Rochester now. Everything's putting up a three of their own. That lands for them. Eli and Kinzer exchanging the ball. Trenton all the way to Shane Lobb. Shane Lobb then handing over to Eli. Then Eli to Kinzer. Kinzer put up a three. Can't get it up. Now is not the time for those threes to be falling, fellas. Oh, Eli with the steal. Interrupting the pass. Bringing it all the way to our side of the court. Yeah, there we go. Slowing it down a little bit. Making sure we get organized. Kinzer with the ball. Kinzer now getting it over to Eli. Yeah, I was thinking about it. He's going to put up for a jumper. Can't get the two to fall. Rands tried to get a hand in on that rebound. Ooh, we could have got a steal going there. Someone's getting the ball. Rochester's got it. Rochester. Ooh, a bit mishap on the pass there. It's going to be out on Rochester. Comets ball. Seem to be tripping up on their pass there. We got a little sweat on the floor there, cleaning up. Not wanting to slip up during the play, I wouldn't imagine. Kendrick's gonna check the ball in for the Comets. Got into Eli. E. Dougie. Hand it back off to Kinzer. Kinzer's then going to send it over to Eli. Once again, Eli tried to get into Rands, but mishap there. Bring it right back over the Zebras. Rochester's going to put it up for the two. Can't get the fall, but they get the foul. Looks like we got Miles getting ready to come in here. Probably after this free throw, I'm assuming he's going to trade out for Rands. Or trade Rands, or sub in for Rands. There we go, that's what I'm looking for. Nope, he's going to sub in for Trenton. And Rands is going to then sub out for Trenton. That was close enough there. Miles McDonald, it's been a while since he's actually been out in the court playing for the Comets. Didn't see him at all during the West Central. Actually, maybe we did see him in West Central. I'm losing track. My memory is not how it once was, folks. Kinzer now with the ball. Send it over to Eli. Eli then heading in for an easy jumper. Easy is over-exaggerating it. He couldn't get that to fall. Pushing foul on. Tell me who it was, ref. Is that Shane Lobb? Yep. Rochester now regained possession of the ball. Zebras now. Keeping things nice and easy. Bringing it to their side of the court. They're looking for an opening. Can they get anything to move for them? Slipped up a little bit. Well, not really slipped up, he's trying to shake him, but you know what I mean. Puts up for a jumper. Man, he got some air. Kinzer tried to get a hand in on the rebound, couldn't get it to fall. Three by Rochester, can't get that to go either. They are on those offensive rebounds, though. Putting up for another three, second time's the charm, can't get it to fall. Trenton on the rebound. Eli now with the ball. Right over to Kinzer. Then into Trenton. Trenton over to Kinzer. Could have popped it up there if he wanted to. Oh, and again, Trenton. Trenton over to Eli. They need to get it in to Shane Lobb. Go for those two. Have Shane Lobb head in and send it into the paint. Kinzer, get over to Miles. He's going to take the shooting. He will be taking the shooting foul. I knew what I was talking about. Couldn't spit it out. It's been a while since we've seen Miles on the line. Oh, first one gets a bad bounce out. Hops right in, hops right out. Miles Lining up for a second shot. Hopefully readjusted. Puts it up. Nah, it doesn't go in either. Rochester tried to get a spin move running for him. Sends it all the way out to the other side of the court. Little mishap on the pass, but they recover. What's he going to do? He's going to drive in. They get pass in to put up for layup. Can't get it to fall. Miles on the rebound, getting it over to Eli. 3 minutes and 33 seconds left on the board. It's Eli thinking. He's going to send it into Kinzer. Oh, Kinzer now loses control of it. Hunter's got it. He gets it over to Trenton. Trenton now over to Miles. Miles to Kinzer. Eli with the deep three. He can't get it to fall. Double dribble on Rochester. Kasten's ball.
Number two, Jacob Nye, returns for the Zebras.
Let's hope Comets can get on a roll of momentum here and get some points scored. Kinzer now with the ball. Yeah, hand it over to Miles. Miles and back to Kinzer. Kinzer. What's he thinking? Gets it out to Eli. Eli gets it over to Trenton. Trenton now hands it off to Eli. Then over to Kinzer. Now what's Kinzer thinking? Over to Trenton. Trenton for a three. He can't get it. Easy rebound for Rochester. Now what's the Zebras thinking? They're going to fire up a three of their own. They go in. Kinzer now with the ball. And so far not looking too good for the Comets. Kinzer gets it over to Eli. Eli now. Kinzer. Kinzer goes in and bounces it off. Rochester player. They're making it out on Rochester.
Three, Austin Hunter returns to the Zebra lineup.
It's a nice move by Kinzer. Keeping it in our ball. Kinzer gets it to Eli. Gets it to Miles. Gets it to Trenton. Trenton now, got it into Miles. Miles then got to put it up for a two, can't get it to fall. Miles kind of threw a head right there on that one Rochester player. Didn't seem too bad though, no one was hurt. Bit mishap on a pass though, even more mishap. Hitting the arm, foul called on. It's 12 for Rochester, still Comets ball. One minute and 24 seconds left on the board here for the third. Comets need to get momentum rolling. Kinzer into Miles. Miles and over to Eli. Eli then into Hunter. Hunter puts it up. He gets the two. They need to do more of that. They need to get Hunter into the paint and send it into him so he can put it up. He's a tall guy. He can make those shots. Layups. That was a nice layup by Rochester, too. Counteract our points by sending them farther ahead. Kinzer to Eli. Hey, Doug, he's sending to Kinzer for a three. Can't get the three to fall. If the threes aren't falling, stop shooting them. Rochester's going to take it easy and hold on to the ball. Smart by him. Not that I have to like it, but it's probably pretty smart. Yep. And just wait out the time. Oh, they're going to make one last play. A little mishap on the pass. What he's going to do, he's going to put it up. Can't get it to fall. Nope. No buzzer beaters today. All right. And the cheerleaders will be doing their little hey song get up as we wait for the fourth quarter. And during this brief intermission, little fun fact for me. Oh, hey, the cheerleaders are actually going to face us somewhat this time. That's nice. That's nice. There we go. Give something for the camera. Not normally do the cheerleaders ever face this way. So it works. Little small fact about me for the intermission. I was a student at Rochester for my kindergarten year. I know, doesn't really mean much, but it's kind of funny to think about that I would have been part of their senior class right now. And I think, if my memory serves me right, I can remember most of the Rochester kids in my class, assuming they're still there as seniors right now. So just a funny little tidbit about me that kind of eased us into the fourth quarter. Comets will have the ball into the fourth quarter.
It'll be the Comets ball to start the fourth quarter.
All right. With the final 8 minutes on the clock, here we go. Kinzer with the ball. That's stolen easily by the Zebras. Puts it up for an easy layup. Let me zoom in a little bit there. There we go. Kinzer sending it to Miles and back to Kinzer. Kinzer then into Miles. Puts it up for an easy two. That's solid. Zebras now. Trying to get something, anything to move for him. Dribbling in, driving in. To get into the paint, easy two. Kinzer and Miles exchange the ball. Kinzer now. Hands it over to Trenton. Trenton takes it out. Hands it over to Miles. Miles is going to drive in. He's up, put it up. Try and make the shot. He's going to get the foul, and he's going to get put on the line. We need more moves. Like that. We need someone to take the ball and just drive in and put it up for two. These threes aren't doing us any good. So, second best thing, go for two. Miles nails his first free throw.
Returning for the Zebras is 23, Brady Perez.
See if we can hit the second one. Make up for those two missed ones earlier. And he fires up. Nope. And only for the second one. Eli on the offensive rebound. He's going to put it up for two. He's got the shooting foul. I put him on the line. That's solid. That's solid. We can use that.
Number five, Eli Douglas hits line with two shots.
Pretty confident. Eli can make these two. First one goes in. Watch and see if the second one heads. He shoots straight in. Easy money. Rochester now at the ball. Rochester also leading 53 to our 31. Rochester just stepped out there slightly, making it Comets ball. Let's not waste the possession.
The three Austin Hunter returns to the Zebras.
Kinzer now with the ball. See how I do. Hand over to Trenton. Trenton then into Miles. Miles is going to put up for two. Can't get to fall. Foul would probably be a reaching on Miles. Rochester now with the ball, taking it to their side of the court. Trying to, anyway. They get it over. Oh, he could have just drove. What are they looking for? Giving it around, sending it into the paint. Ooh, had a little bit of foot trouble there. I think that was the same player that also had that cramp going on for him earlier. Nope, wait, wrong player. I was mixed up. That was number three, if I'm not mistaken. Number 40 is the one who slipped up there. Fell in the comments, still making it Rochester's ball. Rochester's going to put it up for two. That sinks for two. Kinzer now with the ball. Gets it over to Eli. Eli now. What's he going to do? Get it into Miles. Miles is going to send it over to Trenton. Trenton for two. Can't get it to fall. No one but Rochester on the rebound. Rochester now. They're looking for. Drive in slightly stolen by Trenton. Trenton got it over to Eli. That was a bit sketchy there on the pass. Eli then over to Kinzer. Kinzer trying to get the Comets to move. He's going to try and send it into Eli. Foul on Rochester. Still Comets ball. But that foul might have stopped us from pushing any further here. Five minutes and 8 seconds left on the board. Kinzer now with the ball again. Comets trying to get set up for an offensive play. He gets it into, tried to get it over to Hunter. It's going to be taken out of bounds. Rochester's ball. Zebras looking to get something going for them. Send it into the paint to put it up for two. Oh. I apologize for the camera placement. Eli now with the ball. Well, he's going to drive it. Oh, he was going to try and step out. He's going to get caught for travel. 23, Matt Ranz, subbing in for Hunter Shainlob. Zebras now, what's again with the ball? 4 minutes and 20 seconds on the board. Zebras trying to head in the paint. Eli was there to intercept the pass. He's going to send it out to Trenton. Trenton's going to send it all the way out to Miles, who sends it to Kinzer for three. That goes in. Solid three by Kinzer. Zebras are firing passes, stolen. Kinzer got to Miles. Miles got swatted. That was scary. It'll be out on the Zebras, making it still Comets ball. Eli with the ball. Kinzer with the ball. And then Trenton. Trenton got into Eli. Eli tried to put it up for two, but he'll get the foul, putting him on the line. Eli so far has been pretty decent with his free throws. Let's see him make two more. Yeah, first one falls. Not. Just bounces right off the rim. Second shot. Won't fall either. Comet still stuck down 34-57. Rochester will take the ball out, making a Comet's ball once again. Turnover. Allow me to line up there. There we go. Pins it with the ball. Take it around to our side of the court. Get it over to Eli. Eli then Kinzer for a three. Nailed it. Swish. Solid three by Kinzer. Rochester, a bit of a problem with the pass. Trenton almost had the steal. Eli went to get it and get it up to him. Eli for a three. Can't get it to fall. Rochester sending over to their side, putting it up for an easy two. Timeout. Full timeout. Zebras will have that timeout. Well, score so far, 59-37. Less than 3 minutes left on the board for the fourth quarter. Zebras have six fouls, Comets with four. Not exactly what I wanted to see out of the game, but it's been a decent game nonetheless. First half was a bit more eventful than the second. And this will be the first timeout called for this. Not the first timeout called for the second half, but there hasn't been many timeouts called regardless in this entire game now that I think about it. There's been more in the first than there was in the second, I think. If my memory serves me right. Then again, this multitasking's got me using all my motor skills to the max, so can't wait to see this play back. Timeout's up. Comet's breaking out. And we'll be back on the court. Quite a big crowd out here tonight, too, to support both teams. It's always nice to see. And the Comet Band and cheerleaders here. And they will be here to support the team throughout the rest of the week. There are multiple games going on this week. There's tonight's. There's another one another day. And then there's one at Winamax Saturday that I know of. A doubleheader at Winamax Saturday, if I'm not mistaken. Boys and girls. Kenzer's going to try and set up a three, and it's not going to fall. And now Rochester putting up for two. Can't get it to fall. Rands over to Eli. And Eli got it over to Trenton. Trenton now. He's going to drive in. That Rochester player fell hard on top of Trenton. Well, that's going to put Trenton on the line for the shooting foul. That can't feel good in the morning for that Rochester kid. Fell right on top of Trenton's head. Almost like a headbutt to the midsection is what it looked like.
Two shots.
All right, Trenton with two shots. First one falls. Putting the Comets up 38-59. And Trenton can't hit the second one. Rochester got the ball. About 2:15 left. Rochester now trying to set up an offensive play. And Rochester's going to drive in. Tried to put it up for two. Hunter was able to put a hand on to stop it. No fouls called, therefore Eli's got the ball. And he's going to dribble it in, tried to get pass it in to Hunter. To no avail, Rochester got the ball once more. Travel on Rochester. Yeah, Luke Lau and Blake Albright coming in for the Comets. Subbing in for Trenton and Kinzer. Luke Lau and Blake Albright, both JV players. Lau's seen more varsity time than Blake has at this point. Last time I saw Albright come into the game for varsity was back at West Central. A minute 30 left to go. Not a bad time to put in some JV players, get some varsity time in. It's always a good thing to see. Eli with the ball. Got over to Lau. Lau's going to put it out to Albright. And Blake's going to drive in a little bit. Tried to hang on to him, bring it back out. He's going to lose it and send it out of bounds. Zebras ball. Got Brady Hartman coming in for Hunter Shainlob. 1:11 left on the board. Rochester with the ball. Rochester now, keeping things on the arc. They send it in to put it up for a jumper. Can't get it to fall. Eli on the rebound. And they're going to lose on that pass, and Rochester's going to steal and put it right back up for two again. And they're going to get the foul. Oh, that was an and one. Not bad. We got Mark Smith coming into play from the JV team to sub in for Matt Rands. We got most of our JV team out in the play now. The only one of our varsity players still left in there is Eli Douglas. Oh, and Brady. And the three-point play is complete by Rochester. Eli with the ball. Got over to Blake. Blake's thinking I give it back to Eli for a three. It goes in. 21-point deficit with 20 seconds left on the clock. And they're going to hold on to it. Probably run out the clock or make room for at least one more play. Try and go for that illustrious buzzer beater probably, I'd imagine. Nope, they're going to finish it off. Well, that's the game then, folks. Rochester beats Caston 62-41. Thank you all for tuning in to RTC TV4 and being able to withstand my voice for so long. Feel free to check out our YouTube channel, our website at rtctv4.com. And until then, my name is Dakota Hayden, and I'll see you all next time.